So let's see. Yeah, Hector has 39. No one has 36 HP at this point. Like, there's no way. You just have to risk the crit if you want to get this. So, if you attack in close combat the shamans, you're going to get... I mean, can I kill with an Iron Lance maybe? A Slim Lance? They don't do shit to Frenia, so I shouldn't care at all. Yeah. That's nice. 50 experience for Florina. Now same. He doubles with an Iron Blade. But let's do this with the Iron Sword. If he gets killed. If he gets hit, I can heal him with the... with... Priscilla. Easily. This is looking well. Can I steal something here after? See how things go in here. Kill the Black Fang. Kill Eliwood is tankier. You can take out this shaman. Level up for Eliwood. Is it going to be a good level up like before? Skill, speed and luck. Okay. Speed is very good, so I'm not even mad that you didn't get like a defense resistance again. Once I promote Eliwood, I don't know. I'm thinking he might become like 9, 12, 12, 11. And they have, like, yeah, he has 13 speed, but he doesn't have as much defense. So I feel once I promote him, considering Lord Promotion normally gives, like, very, very good bonuses, it's on. Like, he's going to surpass even the Cavaliers. I have nothing against like lords being other shit, but it's nice to use a... Okay, very good, you cannot get damage back. Nice to see a lord that can actually hold his own. And I don't mean like Hector levels of handing your own. But like Eliwood, I feel like Lin is kind of frail for a lord, so that's her problem. While Hector is ridiculously tough for a lord, so Eliwood is kind of the middle lord in everything. I think what I want to do is actually this. I want to equip the javelin. Then get out. You can only attack, yeah, same. So this is looking good, but I may be proven wrong because I see a lot of stars. You have effective weaponry. I still do like nothing and get double because of it. So bye. A longsword, that's effective against cavalry, right? And he only did 8 damage. I mean, it kind of looks better than this heavy spear. So I'm going to store the heavy spear for now. 5 damage. Yeah, not even. I don't double. I do double. Because of the skill level up. Because before I didn't double, I checked. Okay. Estela, por cierto, cierra. Cierra. Sorry, I accidentally kind of press a key and stop the recording. Kill the shop. Get a level of 4 sale. Come on, Shane. Very good. Very good. Very good. That's what I want to see. Okay, at least they appear but don't attack. So an armor slayer and an arrow sword. So this is the boss. This is just an only shaman. Okay. Let's just do a human world. No, no, not a human world yet. Let's just kill him. With an iron blade, why not? Let's go, Shane. Shane has a lot of problems doubling, but once he doubles, he just about kills anything. I mean, Kent still kills more because he's better, basically. The Gaiden Ring is here. But I think you dropped it, so this was a bit stupid, but I gained experience. Krina is level 9, so yeah, she is the better candidate for this. Closer and Hector too, actually. Yeah, just because I feel like there are going to be reinforcements, so I can take them away immediately with both of them. Okay. Let's attack from range first. Then I feel like Raven can take out an archer because archers get a slowdown pretty bad, and I think he had a steel bow. Yes. So can Raven take you out? Yeah, no problem. Raven is okay. He obviously has less experience on him than other units. The thing I think is going to be very good for him is promotion. Because in promotion, he becomes a hero and he gains access. And access are an interesting, like, when you only have access, it's very bad. And you have secondary access, it's normally very good. So let's just equip the iron sword and you are going to get killed. Can I actually kill you in one hit? No. So I will kill you with arrows. If I had a steel lance, I could kill you in one hit. But I would probably miss, so this is better. My face. Go for Kent. Well, you can't reach Eliwood right now, so you get doubled. Okay, Kent. That's good. This game has defense maps, but they are easy. Like, very easy. all the defense map I've seen are actually very much easier than Lucky, and don't like the critical at all. Let's do this. I'm going to circle around him, steal, then immediately come on him and destroy him. He probably stops the chapter. Like once you kill him, the chapter probably ends. Eliwood is level 10 or something now, and Raven is level 8, so yeah. When to do this? I have to use the steel sword, okay. Yeah, don't miss because he has 5 critical because of the Lancer. Got a pure water. Jeez. Not better, but more useful in combat than I already am, that's for sure. And you can heal Kent. To Shaman, as expected. At I don't care. Let's go here and steal the speedworks. And gain a level up actually. Not a very good level up, but a level up. Now can I dodge like reliably? Feel like this is my best chance, so I'm going for it. Unless I can like one hit kill you. No, that's not a good idea, and that's very probably the most damage I can do. So if I get a critical, he's done. If he gets the critical, I'm done. Don't worry about any ambush partnership. You don't know how to fight, go now, or die here. Okay, so I don't get the critical. And I think that's his critical. Yeah, he killed me. Fuck. I'm not getting very lucky, but I feel like this is the best I could do, so let me just come back and try again. Okay, I'm back. This is try 5, I think. Why? This map is easier than some of the previous ones. So why is this map giving me a problem? I don't understand. Chapter 16 was definitely more difficult than this. I have more immediate problems to take care of. Still, I did. This map is yes, kind of weak enemies that I can kill. Okay, very good level up, Eliwood. But even though they are weak, they wreck me completely for some reason. So yeah, that's fun. I like that. Also, Link has Wind Affinity, and Reyna has Light. I think both of them give a void. So, I think the first time I came here, I didn't have the support, I forgot to activate the support. This time I have activated it, so maybe I will get a better chance with the boss. Also, Florina is very good for attacking the mage on the first turn, because she just doesn't care about it. And it's very strange because she always gets the second crit. And it's starting to bug me, not because... It's just that I feel that she may have a... That the RNG might not be resetting, and I don't like that, because as you saw before, I got another death, and the death was still that Vector got killed by the Devil Axe. So I don't know. Like, I don't want to try the Devil Axe now because it would kill me. But at the same time, I'm going to use the Warpel. Actually, I just don't fucking care. But at the same time, I feel tempted to see if RNG is resetting or not, if I'm getting exactly the same RNG for the battles. Because if I am, that's kind of bullshit. Like, if... I don't know anything of this game, so maybe this game does have an RNG that is kept the same when you reset the chapter. Okay, strength. Strength is good. Luck is very good, actually, because it reduces crit and... aumenta a void, so can have the hand axe. That 2% crit. Yeah, but there was no way he could double, and I already killed the longsword up here. I don't know if I got it in camera. I'm just very done with this map right now. Like, it's kind of a nice map. The enemies are weak and they are divided in physical and resistance moves, so it's... I feel like it's supposed to let you train your units. But I can't because they kill me. And when they kill me, I can't kill them. You see, this is a problem. It's an actual problem. So let's kill you. With strength and resistance. Okay. Let's get Erk out of here and heal him. Let's use other units, because Erk is already quite strong, so let's try Raven killing and then taking the other one in enemy phase. As I said, that crit... Pure water? Yeah, pure water doesn't... I was thinking just now, maybe a pure water can help me survive the boss. Can't, because the boss has a Luna. Only 5 strength. SOT. No problem, he said. Just before he got killed again. Probably. Kill you with another critical. I'm tempted of letting Florina go against the boss, but Like, yeah, she has a lot of skill, a lot of speed, but can she do it? I don't know if she can. Because it's not about being a good unit. Throwing is a good unit. Lin, I feel, is a good unit at this point of the game. But this is what I need. This, or more so, the boss not getting this. So it's more about getting lucky than about being good. And I don't like that enemies with crit. I can take them. I can like stun them. You can risk going against them with a unit that could die, or you can choose a unit that is tanky enough to resist them even if they get a crit. That's my view. Okay, strength. Let's take it. But then you get, you know, a unit that can kill you whether you are like trained and the tank of your group or not, because no one is going to have the 36 HP at this point of the game, right? Like, that's just plain impossible, I feel. Maybe Marcus. Maybe Marcus, actually. Maybe I should have brought Marcus to this map. That's why I'm having so much trouble. But even Marcus, I think, had like 32 HP. So I don't know. You are fine. You're fine. The problem is not you. We all know whose group has the problem. Ceiling. Level up 4 Priscilla. Level 5 only? Really? HP and magic, not so very good level up, but only level 5. I think I've been using her for a lot of time now. Okay. How much movement do you have? Five movements, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. No, no. Not a problem, because if someone attacks, they are going to be here, so... This is still the speedwings. And let's try again. Let's just try again. But now... Is this 85 versus 80? Okay, so Lin is the better option. So I can bring Florina here. Why? Because I want the support. Now, can I get more above? No, but I think I got more critical. Let's go for it. 24 critical. Come on, don't worry. Blah, 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 blah. Can I please get a critical? Yes! You're dead! You possess this much power! Marshall. Fuck off! Zoldam, I'm going to remember your name, you're fucking annoying, boss! And speed, okay. And even. Okay, speed. I guess speed is good.
Hoi, I'm back!
Now, who wants to die first?
Orpheus, you've heard them already?
No, there are two shaman there, you can take them, I don't care.
You've heard them already, notch down, whelps.
Those silos were no match for us. They were a match. They definitely were a match. Eliwood is like, fuck off, Hector. You got killed twice by other villains. Ah, Ninning, you can't come out yet. There's blood everywhere. I said that so lightly, I don't know if it was even audible. Look out.
I'm sorry.
Are you okay, Ninian?
Ninian? Is that me? Is that my name?
Convenient and missy, as I kind of feared. Let's roll with it.
Ninian, what's happened to you? My head is so foggy. Am I at sea?
I feel like she knows something very important, like she has a very important role in the story. So to justify that she doesn't tell us at this point of the game, they got the convenient amnesia, then they are going to take it away when it's, well, convenient. We find you adrift in a small boat.
Those come after the girl, it seems. Will you take her with you? I'm afraid she... well, she might be cursed, you know.
Cursed?
Are you suggesting we leave Ninian behind?
We can take her with us, can we?
We're heading for the Dread Isles. Dread for a reason, you know.
Regardless, she goes with us.
Lindis? When I saw her, I remember something. The last time I saw Ninian. She and her brother were being hunted by some Dark Rock man.
Dark Rock? Are you sure?
Yes, I think it must be the Black Thumb. Didn't occur to me before, but now I'm certain.
How can you be so sure?
I can't explain. There's something in the air that hints at their involvement.
But that's actually a very good reason, okay? If it's true, then she's likely to be attacked again.
Almost certainly. We can't leave her behind. We'll watch over her, please.
I understand. We should be by her side to protect her.
Thank you.
We're all going to that island. Will you come with us?
Yes. Please, take me with you.
I love her spread. Like her map spread. This is a cool backdrop. Reminds me of like, I don't know if you know Tonton, French. No, actually I think it's from Belgium, a comic. It's European, so if you're not European maybe you don't know, but it's a very popular comic and it has a one of the chapters is called the Black Isle. And it's like in Scotland, it's an isle of black rock, and I always liked that, like the cover of that comic book, and this backdrop really reminds me of it, like with a purple sea, with the black rocks, and
we've arrived.
Thank you very much.
We'll wait 2 weeks. Finish up by then.
It's more than enough time.
And I've got a half-wit sailor who wants to go sightseeing. Come here, Dar.
Oh. He wants to go sightseeing. Or is he going to join?
I'm here, Captain. Ready to serve.
We're pleased to have you.
So the moon feature is his sterliness. Maybe he'll come in handy.
Come on, Captain. I'm better than that.
If not so much. I can't thank you enough.
Come back alive, that's all the thanks I need.
Right, farewell.
We'll be back before you know it.
They are good people, even among pirates. I don't think the old man and his group are your average pirates. Somewhere within that forest is the Dragon's Gate.
Eliwood, no matter what it takes, we're coming back with your father.
Yeah. They are Eliwood is telling so much about, like, I want to get my father alive, we're coming back with your father. They are mentioning the father so much lately. I'm getting death flags. Lots of death flags. We're coming back with his corpse, I think. We'll surely find him. We'll do our best to make it so. You're right. Let's make preparations to enter the forest. Oh! Dragon's Gate. Ninen, what is it? It's nothing. Yeah. So, a bit of an Asura vibe there, like, I know more than I can tell you, but the story conveniently makes me unable to tell you. So yeah, I'm mysterious, and I'm blue-haired. And I get it on with the lore. Yeah, I see where this is going. Don't get me wrong, I feel like she's better done than Azura already at this point. I really hate Fate's story. Someday I'm going to play Fate's in this channel, and it's just going to be me ranting at everything that is wrong. Not Conquest, because I actually like Conquest. It's just yeah, the story is bad, but still, like, the gameplay is so good it compensates. And Birthright, a lot of people say Birthright's story is kind of bland, and I agree. Birthright's story is not a good point, but gameplay is actually quite good. I don't know why people don't like Birthright gameplay. Is it just because enemies don't have skills? Birthright is very strange, actually, because enemies do have skills, but only when they can't be captured. Like, it's just like the game is going against you capturing people, because the chapter with the wolfskin, they have skills. The chapter with the faceless in for Dragonfall, they have skills. So people do have skills, but the only appearances of people having skills are people that you can't capture and recruit. So it always seemed pretty funny to me that way, but like Birthright Lunatic, still much, much better than things like Awakening or even, I'd say I kind of enjoy the gameplay more than Echoes, and I do enjoy Echoes to some point. I just think it's a bit grindy, but Birthright you can beat without grinding. And yeah, of course Ryome is a red button, but well, I'm not here to talk about Fates, but yeah. One day I will play the games, and then I'm going to say, as I say now, that Revelation is utter shit. This game, however, is no Revelations. This was a... So I said, oh, different chapters are too easy, and the game immediately punished me for thinking so. I thought I can use the Devil Axe just to flex on... Yeah, I got immediately destroyed. I still think the Devil Axe is kind of worth it. I don't think I think I started telling this in last chapter, but then I got sidetracked by something. The good thing about the Devil Axe is this game... there are a few things I know about this game, like mechanics wise, and I know this game has like weapon experience. Each weapon gives different weapon experience, so you don't gain the same weapon rank by using a normal iron sword than you get by using like an iron blade. I know blades give more weapon experience, so like if you have the option of killing with both, it's kind of a way of motivating you to kill with the iron blade, because then you get more experience. For the weapon, I mean. Not for the character, you know what weapon... I mean weapon rank in general. It makes you go faster to reach faster, higher level. And they are like marked by... They give you like one experience, two experiences. The stabs, of course, they give you like the ones that recover most, like physical recover or things like this, give you a lot of weapon experience. I think warp gives you like a shit ton. Torch, I know the torch stuff is commonly named the experience stuff because it gives a lot of experience and it's just, you can just spam it in a fog map. So, the thing about the Devil Axe is it has like 8, so it's like attacking once with a Devil Axe is the 8 times the experience of attacking with an Iron Axe, and that's just ridiculous. So if you can attack with a Devil Axe, you probably should, because like burning like 10 uses of a Devil Axe with a character is going to get them to the next rank like immediately, like boom. So I wanted to use the Devil Axe a little bit, yes, because I want to get Hector to A rank like quickly, so that when I first get a Silver Axe I can give it to him, because I don't have really any good axe user, and Silver Axes are very good. Like I think they are just light enough for Hector not to get slowed down. They also have like incredible might, so. But it's just not worth it. This chapter was kind of a training chapter for many units, but it's still not a chapter where you can fuck around and use the Devil Axe just because you want. So from now on, no risky business. No risky business. Especially Hector, because Hector doesn't have a lot of luck. I think he has like 5. So yeah, he... Isn't it like 31 minus your luck? So he has a 26 or maybe a bit lower, but a very high chance of damaging himself. But in the end, the whole chapter, it was kind of my fault to... The things, like, I cannot blame them on the design of the map. The only thing I can blame on the design is the boss. I think the boss is stupid. And I know it's an optional boss. So yeah, I could have left him alone and just stealing the speed wings, then rescuing Matthew and getting out of there, then surviving for 11 turns, but it's a boss, you want to kill him, and he's stupid, like, he's pure RNG. I don't like this boss, I'm going to remember him as a bad boss in this game. Anyway, this has been it for this part, and this has been Pomum. Like, subscribe, leave a comment, and I will see you in the next part.